All right, we are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef Joe Simone is here from the Sunnyside. We are making Italian vegetable soup. That is what's on the menu. Joe can give us the fancy name for it. Go for it.
It's called Passato di Verdure.
Very nice.
Sounds a lot ritzier in Italian, doesn't it, Will?
I want to go with Italian vegetable soup. Hey, first of all, it's great to see you.
You too.
It's nice having you here today. What you're going to make also sounds delicious today.
So delicious, so healthy, and really, really easy.
And you've got the ingredients, simple stuff to put together. A lot of people may have this in their home already.
Totally.
So let's go over it.
Okay, extra virgin olive oil. Little crushed chili peppers if you like heat. If you don't, leave them out. Celery, onions. There's supposed to be carrots on this table, but I don't know where they went going from my house to here this morning. Sorry. Anyway, shallots, garlic. This is kale. Mm-hmm. And then in here is a little spinach and also Swiss chard. These are the stems from the Swiss chard that I'm going to put in the soup. You'll see when we get to that point. But anyway, we're going to use both the stems and the leaves.
So this is what we're going to put together. We're going to put this all in the pot here. And you said very vegan, right?
Right. Well, we're going to cover it with water.
Right.
And then turn it on and simmer it for an hour.
Easy enough to do.
Yep.
Joe's back with us. We're going to put this together in just a little bit. It's going to smell. It's going to taste fantastic. Perfect for a night like tonight. Back to you. Yes, we are. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Joe Simone is here from the Sunnyside making Italian vegetable soup. He is ready to go. Now, you were selling yourself a little short a little while ago. You're saying, you know, this is, no, you really were, because you're a chef. You make great things, but you're saying this is so easy. You don't even have to mix this up or anything.
You don't even have to stir this dish.
Right.
That's what's so easy. And you just have to think when you're adding the ingredients, you put the harder things in first. Okay?
Okay.
Celery, hard, goes to the bottom of the pan.
Right.
Obviously, I added the olive oil first to the bottom of the pan.
Olive oil is what we need for the bottom of the
Swiss chard stems.
That looks great.
Yep. Shallots.
Mm-hmm.
And notice how they're just sort of cut up. They're not finely cut. This whole thing's going to be pureed, so it doesn't matter as long as they're about the same size.
Okay.
I'm going to put the garlic in. Look, that's a lot of garlic.
That's good.
Yeah. It smells good, too.
Smells good.
Now, this is going to be the spinach and the Swiss chard.
Mm-hmm. Dump that over. So far, Joe, very easy. We're just dumping things. Now you're throwing things out.
That's right. Sorry, Will. Okay, notice. Would you pass me one of those pitchers of water, please?
I can do that.
Actually, if you want to just do
As
the honors.
As your lovely assistant, I will just pour this whole thing in?
Pretty much. I'll tell you when to stop.
Okay.
You want to add enough water, or if you have vegetable stock, or if you want to have chicken stock, but otherwise it's not vegan. Keep going.
Okay.
Yeah.
Pouring it in?
Yeah, all the way.
All right.
Okay. So what
you
have...
Well, that was easy, Joe.
Yeah, you have it almost covering the vegetables.
Right.
Okay. Now, we're going to turn the stove on to high.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as it comes to a simmer,
right.
Turn the heat down, cover it, let it cook for an hour.
And that's it.
That's it. Well, then we're going to grind it up right in this pot.
Okay, so then we're going to put everything together in the pot. So that was simple and easy to do. Lots of great vegetables in here. All good stuff for you. Easy enough.
I forgot to tell you to add salt.
All right. Add a little salt. That's it. That's it, Joe. We're going to fire you.
And I know you like spice.
I do like spice. Turned up a notch.
There we go.
All right, we're going to puree stuff. We're going to eat stuff. We're going to talk about the Sunnyside in just a little while. In the meantime, back to you. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning with one of our favorite guys, Joe Simone's here from the Sunnyside, who make an Italian vegetable soup. He's giving Meg a lesson in how to use that blender.
So just,
he's like, finally, something healthy to eat.
That's right. Put it down on the bottom and now push. Because that's a lot safer and it'll keep your beautiful dress from getting soup all over it.
Okay.
See? So,
thanks,
Megan's doing this.
Right.
We started with the vegetables in the pot.
Okay.
It came to a simmer, cooked it for an hour.
Mm-hmm.
Then you put this in, this immersion blender, and you grind it all up.
This is awesome.
Okay? What could be easier than this?
Can you also blend frosting and whipped cream and stuff like that in here? Okay.
I don't know.
Probably not.
I've never tried to make whipped cream in this, but
our blender just broke, so I was just curious.
You might give it a try.
What's the consistency have to be of this?
It can be anything you want, but the more water, the thicker it is.
Right.
Okay. I'm just going to show you.
And I'm not going to do this anymore because it's loud.
Yeah, it's already done. So I'm just going to take this out of the way.
Just
put that right there. Now, if you see how the consistency is,
right.
It's soupy.
Right. So,
right?
Yes.
Perfect.
You know? That's Italian vegetable soup.
You know, I've got to tell you, I love this recipe. I've been making it all summer. Mm-hmm. My family and I joined a community-supported agriculture.
And tell everybody what that is,
okay,
too.
Okay, CSA. What it is we paid money to new urban farmers at the beginning of the season, mm-hmm. and every week they give us a share of the production of the farm that week.
Oh, nice.
Wow. So we don't get to pick what we get.
Okay.
But it's kind of like a surprise every week.
Right.
That's nice.
And, you know, some people think it's a pleasant surprise to get a lot of kale every week.
Right.
Other people may not. But I can tell you that we turned a lot of kale into this delicious and healthy soup.
And I never knew you could do that with kale, because I know kale chips. You could put kale in
salad.
Sure, all good.
So this is good, too.
So this is what I have been making all summer.
It really inspired you.
Serve it hot on a cold day. Mm. Serve it cold on a hot day.
Right, and it's still good.
I have a little quinoa. So if you have anything left over, like rice or whatever mm-hmm. from the night before, or even some croutons,
right.
they go well with the soup. And if you don't, you can just have it like this.
And this is nothing but healthy stuff. And you were saying great for anyone who's who's vegan out there, this would be delicious.
And for all of us budding young vegans, right?
And you were saying if you have any leftover rice, any leftover, I had quinoa for maybe 2 weeks after I made it. I didn't realize how much I made.
Right, how much you make.
But it's so healthy for you.
Take a spoon.
Oh,
you're
going to
get your own?
I got one.
Now,
okay.
Is this like somebody who needs to have like gluten-free stuff? Are we cool with
there's
this?
There's zero gluten in
zero
here.
Zero gluten. All right. So you're cool with this?
Is it really hot?
I don't know.
Mm-mm.
It looks good to me.
How is that?
You know when your body just needs like something healthy? Like I've been eating a lot of sugar this morning.
Yep.
This tastes really good.
Yeah.
And it makes you feel good.
And it makes you feel good.
I don't know about you, but my doctor is telling me to eat more vegetables mm-hmm. and more fiber
and
less meat
right.
and less animal stuff.
It's like mm-hmm. a little, it's like, there's a little kick in it too.
There's a little,
a little hot, a little too spicy.
No, I love it.
Mm. Okay. This is great for even like a fall day.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I even brought this to the beach for a picnic one day this summer.
That's really good. All right, you cook up so many great things. Great breakfast place. Thank you. About what's going on. Sunnyside.
Well, we're really excited.
Yes.
You know, we've been on hiatus for the last year mm-hmm. almost. We are going to be purchasing a building on Child Street in Warren.
Okay.
In fact, tonight we have the hearing for our liquor license transfer. So hopefully the gods will smile at the town council.
Meg and I should vote. All in favor?
I know. I'm thinking myself. Oh, God, I hope so. Because
you got two votes here. Thank you.
And it's always nice to enjoy a cocktail while you're having something delicious.
Well, we thank you. We're looking forward to getting open in the fall.
And what's the process been like getting this all together?
It's been long,
right?
But very fulfilling. The thing is that we have created a wonderful community of people around mm-hmm. us who
isn't
are
nice?
Being patient and very supportive, and we just can't wait to get open for everyone.
And you said it's been on hiatus for a while, but I mean for a whole year, but I mean you've been in here, you've been cooking, you've been present at events that we've seen you at, so it's not like you've been sitting by.
No, it's not like we haven't been doing anything, and I'm so proud that my whole staff is going to come back.
Mm. That's great.
And
that's
so nice. We're going to have a wonderful time when we get open again.
That sounds great.
Good.
Can I just add one more thing?
Yeah.
First thing I said to you was, is it really salty? Sometimes soup
is it salty?
So salty. It's not.
No, not at all.
Like I said, I could taste that kick. Mm. It's good. Can't wait till
Excellent.
You guys open.
Me neither.
I'm still eating.
Mm.
It's really good. It tastes delicious. I would even eat it just like the way it is without even having to grind it up.
Yeah.
Can
even
I take
everything.
One of those?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah.
Everything
please, help yourself.
Kale.
There might be a little salt right on top of that.
This is all good stuff. We are having our soup here with Joe from the Sunnyside. Michaela is out hobnobbing with the rich and famous out there at the Jeffrey Osborne Celebrity Classic. What's going on?